questions for Coach? Start on the right side with Gabe.
Jake, what can you tell us about how the battle's gone at the quarterback? Is it wide open right now? I know someone said that he's given both guys opportunities with the first team. What can you tell us about that competition?
Yeah, definitely. We opened it back up, and we've had some good experiences throughout, last week in live scrimmage situations and, actually going through, some scripted plays as well. So you can put them in some, different scenarios, each one, and still challenge them in different ways. But, yeah, it's still wide open. We're going to split the reps today and possibly on Wednesday, and then Thursday we'll probably have a declared starter by then, and they'll take all the reps for that Thursday practice.
Left side, Kate.
You went through this in the offseason with, judging those two guys and the two of them competing, but, Kenny started 8 games. How have you seen him respond to this challenge?
Yeah, that is tough, especially when you've started for 8 games and then be thrown in that situation where your job's on the line. But I think he's handled it pretty well. He's out there competing. He's motivating those younger guys when he's going with the number two offense. And, I see that his leadership is building up even more, just having that opportunity to go out there and run with the twos. But, yeah, it is a different situation going back to, like, what we went through in fall camp. But, I think he's handled it, and he's still out there competing to get this job and going into Louisiana Monroe.
Right side, Gabe.
That question was about Kenny, right? I was just making sure. Okay, conversely, how has Kyle – I just want to make sure because I don't want to ask the same question.
Right.
There's a lot going on here. How has Kyle handled his opportunity now seeing a light potentially that maybe wasn't there previous?
No, it was, Kyle came into my office and he asked me if this is for real. And I said, yeah, it is. So he's like, good, because I'm going to try to go get it. So, I'm pleased with how he's handled the whole situation from fall camp and, through those 8 games leading up to this point. And, he shows up every day. He gets extra work in, and you can tell that he's really, trying to exert himself to go out there and try to win this job.
Left side, Suzanne.
Jake, did you have that same conversation with Kenny, talking about opening up the thing, and how did he react to it in your office?
Kenny's a competitive kid anyways. And, when we said that we're going to rep Kyle some this week as well, and you guys are going to split reps accordingly with the ones and the twos, he understood. And, you could see that the approach and the pep in his step, that it was a little different when he went out for our walkthrough and for our scrimmage that day. But, yeah, obviously, that's not the greatest news to give a kid, but I think he's responded well to it, and he's competed well, and he's still got an opportunity to get that job back right now.
Left side, KO.
Operating under the assumption that Kenny keeps the job, how beneficial is it for him to run so many more plays now with the number twos?
It's always good to go with the number twos, and I think that's the best way to learn at times, because you're going to have protection issues as well, and see how creative you can be of just keeping the play alive, extending that play, or finding your hot answers, and also getting a feel for if your run game's not working, what do I need to do on the perimeter. So it makes you think a little bit more when you don't have that comfortability of your number one offensive line out there as well. So
Go to the back, Daryl, standing.
You kind of talked about a little bit, but your offensive line, because your problems offensively has not been who the quarterback is, but could you talk about maybe what was addressed with your offensive line during the bye week?
Yeah, a lot of it is physicality, effort and energy and emotion. Those are like pretty much the four things that we talked about on a consistent basis with everybody. And, anyway, this is a physical league, and you better come to fight each week. And, we said that we were going to mix it up and still compete for, those starting jobs. All 5 positions are open, and we've been giving guys opportunities to compete. So, yeah, mainly the whole thing is being physical.
Left side, Suzanne.
So, Louisiana Monroe runs a 3-3-5. Mm-hmm. Have y'all faced that kind of formation this year?
No, we haven't. It's a unique scheme. They're a very aggressive scheme. It's probably the most aggressive scheme that we will face on the entire year. They play man free and they blitz about every single snap. So,
have teams been able to run against them though? Because I guess that would be a weakness in a 3-3-5 is the run
Yeah, the teams have struggled to run against them, you know, especially in spread sets, because it's a 3-3-5 and you're outnumbered in the box for the run game. So you have to get creative with the run game, you know, and you got to hope that with all the games that they play, hopefully they don't hit the right gap and you can crease them in the run game. So it is a unique scheme. Our offense, we haven't seen that very often. So, you know, we've been getting some good quality reps at it so far, and which we're a day ahead on it. So, yeah, it's definitely going to be a good challenge, especially how aggressive they are and how they force so many turnovers. They always tend to get a turnover every single game.
Right here, Olin.
Hi, Jake. Did you sense that y'all ever needed to, you know, tell the guys, remind them that there's still stuff to play for, or you know, is that an issue at all?
Oh no, they know that they need to play for. You know, especially with the bowl seedings and just to get back into the top 25 and just get talked about and get back into the hype of the bowl system and where we can go. So, you know, the kids know what's at stake and just the opportunity to go out there and play in these venues as well and be on national TV each week. They know that they got to step up their game and that they're competing for the pride and competing for Texas A&M.
A couple more here in front. Brent.
How would you evaluate Mike Matthews' play, maybe in particular his snapping at this point, and is there a little bit of a cause for concern along those lines?
No, there's no cause for concern. You know, Mike's a great player for us. He's one of our vocal leaders. I love the intensity that he plays with. You know, at times, like, it's pretty tough in the trenches in the SEC. And just always talking to him about it and the entire offensive line, they always say it's like going into a street fight each week, and you know you gotta bring some physicality every single week. And sometimes when, you know, you might be getting beat, which that happens. You know, sometimes your snaps tend to sell a little over the head or a direction that he tends to be moving. But you know, I haven't seen any of the snaps, you know, rarely affect any plays besides that one in Alabama down there on the goal line.
Anything else for Coach Spavital? All right, thank you.